Hello and welcome to this Lumineth Realm Lords painting video. In this video, we're going to be taking you through a step-by-step guide on how to paint the armour, the robes and the plumes of the variant colour scheme of the Great Nation of Ymetrica. Now the model we're going to be using is a Venari Aurelan Warden, that's going to be our example, and we need to undercoat the model before we do this. As you can see here, I've used grey sear, which is perfect for the colours we'll be applying. Now the first area we're going to concentrate on is the armour, and the first colour we'll be using is Iron Hand Steel. So I'm going to grab a medium layer brush, and I'm just going to apply a little bit onto the palette. Little touch of water, and then we're going to start picking out all that armor. That's both the breastplate, the shoulder pauldrons, as well as the scale mail. So we're basically covering anything that looks like it should be armor. And if you're not sure, just check the box for details. Now that we've base coated the armor, we're going to move on to the next steps, which is to apply a contrast and then do a highlight. Now the contrast we're using is Keeling Green. I'm going to be thinning this down with contrast medium, and the highlight will be Stormhost Silver. But first of all, let's get that contrast mix. So I'm going to apply a couple of dollops of contrast medium, so it's two parts of that and then one part of a Keeling Green, and just mix that together like so. And then I'm just going to try not to overload my brush too much, just spin it around to get a decent point, and then I'm going to start coating that all over the armour that we just painted. So take your time, and if you do find it pulling the recesses, just use your brush to soak up any excess. Now that the Keeling Green is dry, we're going to start highlighting with Stormhost Silver. So you've got like the bit of banding around the armour, so I'm just going to start picking that out like so. Then you've got the flat panels as well. In some places you've got hard edges that you can pick out, like I'm just doing here. And then you've got the scale mail. I'm actually just going to layer the scale mail pretty much apart from in those deeper recesses, and that'll give it a real nice blingy effect. There we are, with the armour now completed, we're going to move on to painting the robes. Now the first colour we'll be using is Night Lord's Blue, which will be our base coat. Then we're going to layer up using Cantor Blue. After that we'll start our first highlight, which will be a Latop Blue, then finish off with Hoef Blue as a final highlight. So first of all, let's start with Night Lord's Blue. So it's a nice dark blue this, so I'm just going to apply a couple of dollops onto the palette, a little bit of water, just so it's not too thick and goopy. I'm using a small layer brush for this as well, because I want a bit more control when doing this base coating. So I'm going to be doing the main robes. The inner robe will be doing the same colour as the plume, so we're just doing these main robes here and also the sleeves. Now you've got a bit of a key line or trim around here. If you do splodge that, just tidy back up with grey sear. With the Night Lord's Blue now dry, we're going to start layering over using Cantor Blue. So we're looking for the raised areas of the cloth, but leaving that Night Lord's Blue in those recesses. Now that we're layered with Cantor Blue, we're going to start highlighting, and the first colour is going to be a Latop Blue. So we're just looking for the raised areas. They're going to be quite thick and broad highlights, these are. And get preparation for the next highlight after. Take time, and if you make any mistakes, just tidy back up with Cantor Blue. Now that we've done that first highlight, we're going to do our final highlight, which will be much thinner and only in select places, just on the actual tips of the creases. For this, we're using Hoef Blue. There we are, with the dark blue robe now done, we're going to move on to painting the plume and also just a little bit of skirt in between the robes. Now for this we'll be starting off with Talisar Blue, thinned down with contrast medium, so one part Talisar Blue, two parts contrast medium, and we'll finish off with a highlight of Blue Horror. But first of all, let's get that contrast ready. So what I'm going to do is get a couple of dollops of contrast medium and then one dollop of Talisar Blue, and then mix that together like so. I'm using a medium layer brush here because again I can get a nice point to it, but it's not too big. So once I've got a nice point like so, I'm ready to start applying that to the plume. So I'll start with the plume first, then I'll move down to the skirt after. With the Talisar Blue and contrast medium mix now done, we're going to start highlighting with Blue Horror. So I'm just going to start on the fold of the clothes here. Just doing a nice fine highlight down like so. When you get to the actual plume, I'm just going to like pick bits on the top like that, just stamp with my brush like so. With the plume now done, the armour, robes and plumes of the variant colour scheme of the Great Nation of Ymetrica is now done. Now remember, by following this guide, you can apply this to any models in your Lumineth collection. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoy painting your own Lumineth Realm Lords from the Great Nation of Ymetrica, and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.